Newark, the boardroom at the headquarters of New Jersey Transit here does not often fill with spontaneous applause. But it did on Monday morning, not for an action the agency's board took, but for one it put off. After the board took the unusual step of rescheduling its monthly meeting for Martin Luther King's birthday, a state and federal holiday, a crowd of Hoboken residents showed up to protest. The residents wanted to stop New Jersey Transit from helping a privately owned ferry company turn a site on the Hoboken waterfront into a maintenance facility for its fleet. Hoboken officials had started moving toward seizing the property with plans for transforming it into a public park. To preserve it for industrial use, the ferry company, New York Waterway, asked New Jersey Transit to buy the site and lease it back to the company. Over the objections of Hoboken's new mayor, Ravinder Espala, and his predecessor, Don Zimmer, the agency's board had been scheduled to vote on the purchase last Wednesday. But the meeting was postponed because the board did not have a quorum of four members. The board then rescheduled the meeting for Monday, even though state and federal government agencies were closed. The holiday did not deter Mr. Bala and dozens of Hoboken residents from flooding into New Jersey Transit's building in downtown Newark. They arrived loaded with arguments against helping New York Waterway move its maintenance and fueling operation from neighboring Weehawken to the middle of Hoboken's revitalized waterfront. Mr. Bala said the agency's plan to take the last missing link in our public waterfront park system and permanently keep it as an industrial site would undermine decades of sound policy and community planning and the progress we are making. He also called the timing of the rescheduled meeting a slap in the face to the legacy of Dr. King. As of late Sunday, New Jersey Transit was signaling that the board would vote on the matter on Monday. Gov. Chris Christie's last full day in office. The board is chaired by Mr. Christie's Commissioner of Transportation, Richard T. Hammer. Mr. Christie's successor, Governor-elect Philip D. Murphy, who has been sharply critical of Mr. Christie's oversight of New Jersey Transit, took issue with the planned vote last week. This deal, being rushed through on the last day of the Christie administration and on a federal holiday, no less is emblematic of everything the public has come to loathe about NJ Transit and another reason why it needs a complete overhaul, Mr. Murphy said. Giving away millions of dollars on the way out the door, when the current system isn't even adequately funded, is simply irresponsible. Then on Monday, with the boardroom brimming with hostility, Mr. Hammer announced that the vote on the proposed acquisition in Hoboken would be deferred. He did not say why. Mr. Bala called the postponement a huge victory for Hoboken and its efforts to complete a stretch of public space running the length of the city along the Hudson River. The property that New York Waterway acquired late last year is the missing link in that plan. Known as Union Dry Dock, the site has been used for repairing barges and other vessels for decades. It is the last vestige of what once was an industrial waterfront, teeming with longshoremen and factory workers. The ferry company bought it for $11.5 million as a replacement for its longtime base of operations in Weehawken. New York Waterway sold that site 20 years ago to a developer that now wants to construct residential buildings there, said Armand Pohan, the chairman of New York Waterway. At the time, the ferry service was much smaller and the company lacked the foresight to imagine what a large role it would play in the region's transportation network, Mr. Pohan said. Appearing at the New Jersey Transit meeting, Mr. Pohan said the loss of the Hoboken site could threaten the ferry company's survival. Do you want a ferry system? He asked. Hoboken officials said they were willing to help the ferry company come up with a plan B, perhaps in Bayonne. but they were adamant that the Union Dry Dock site was destined to be a park. The city sent an appraiser to the site last week to help determine how much to offer for it before resorting to eminent domain to force a sale. The acquisition of this land is a major priority for Hoboken and we will make it happen, Mr. Bala said. There are other options and we will find them because we want to make sure that New York Waterway has the ability to expand and grow as well.